The recent update has introduced a Constrain components feature as a way of assembling components. If you have used SOLIDWORKS before, this is similar to how mates work. Let's take a look at a few simple examples. We have a cuboid and a cylinder here. We want to place the cylinder on the cuboid. Go to Assemble, Constrain Components. Select the base of the cylinder. This populates the geometry selection of component 1. Select the top face of the cuboid. This populates the geometry selection of component 2. This automatically introduces a coincident mate between the selected faces. You can introduce a gap by entering an offset value. You can also flip the orientation. Let's confirm. This adds a step in the timeline. We have not fully constrained the cylinder. It is still free to move along the face of the cuboid. So what if we need to position the cylinder on the center of the rectangular face? The good thing about this new feature is that we can also make use of sketch geometry. So let's make the sketch that was used to create the cuboid visible. This is a center point rectangle. Double-click on the step in the timeline to edit. Click on the plus sign to add a constraint. Select the cylindrical face, followed by the center point of the sketch rectangle. This aligns the axis of the cylinder to the sketch point. The cylinder will now be fully constrained. If we resize the sketch rectangle, the position of the cylinder updates accordingly. You are not limited to using sketch points. Solid sketch lines and construction lines can be used as well. Let's take a look at another example. We want to assemble this knob into this hole. Begin the Constrain Components command. Select the cylindrical face of the knob. Let's try clicking on the Preview on the Hover option. If we hover over the hole, it guesses that you are trying to create a concentric mate and gives us a preview. If we hover over an edge, it tries to center the cylinder on that edge. This might be a bit distracting, and not all will find this useful. Let's disable that. Select the hole. Click on the plus sign to add a constraint. Select the bottom face of the wing. And the top face of the plate. Introduce an offset value. The knob is still free to rotate. I have prepared construction planes for the two components. We can make use of these construction planes to set an angle. It is important that you activate the appropriate component when creating these planes. Let's go back into the Constrain step. Click on the plus sign to add a constraint. Select this construction plane, which is a mid plane of the wing, followed by this plane, which is a mid plane of the plate. Change the type of constraint to angle. Adjust the angle. You can flip or enter a negative value. The knob is now fully constrained. This is just a quick overview of the constraint components feature. Hope you have found this useful. Do share your experience with this new feature in the comments below.